Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel. Today in this video, we are going to
do this aging effect using all free software.
So the three free applications that I use to do this effect are, of course, HitFilm Express, which is free. I also used a software called EB Synth, and I will leave a link in the description below to that website where you can get that. And then I also just used a cell phone application that made my face look older. It's called FaceApp. So the first thing that you want to do is you want to bring up HitFilm Express and bring your raw footage into it. EB Synth cannot work with footage that is MP4 or an AVI or something like that. It requires a image sequence. So what I'm going to do is drag my raw footage here on, and I'm going to remove the sound by hitting the Alt key and just dragging it into the video area. Then from here, I will export the contents. I can go ahead and create a new folder, and I'm just going to call this video, and I will place it in there, and then I'm going to select the type of preset, which will be a PNG sequence. And then I will go ahead and I will export that as a PNG sequence. As soon as that has been exported, then I can go ahead and pick an image that I think best represents or shows all the information that I want to use in my changed video. And in this case, I'm going to use image number 19. My mouth is open. Everything else is in the frame. This seemed to me to be a good one. So I took this and I downloaded it into my cell phone so that I could create the aging effect. So I downloaded FaceApp onto my cell phone, and then I brought the picture in and simply clicked on the picture so that I could see it. Then I selected age and I decided to go with old, right? Although I could have gone with cool old or young or something like that, but I decided to go with old. And then I saved that. And I brought that back into my computer. Then I'm going to go ahead and create a new folder, and I will call this folder Keys. Okay, and I will place that image inside. So now I have a video folder with all 207 images. That's how long this is. And I also have a folder called Keys with the single image that is my key image, with the older looking face. So now it's time to bring up EB Synth. To do this, all you have to do is go to their website, download the zip file that contains it, unzip that file, and then run EB Synth. There is no installation. Now, your antivirus software may say, hey, wait a minute, can I take a look at this? Feel free, there's nothing wrong with it. And then when you have it open, you can go ahead and start working with it. So EB Synth is originally a software that was designed to create cartoon looks with video footage. So you might make a cartoon out of your one key frame and then try to run it. As you can see, it didn't work very well for me when I did it, but it worked pretty well when I used the cartoon effect that comes with HitFilm. And also, I did it with something called Deep Dream Generator. I will leave a link in the description below for that. And both of those came out pretty nice. So I decided to do this with the aging effect just to see if it would work that way as well. And it's very simple to use EB Synth. What you do is you have a project directory. That's where it's going to end up. You have your keyframe or keys, and you just grab your keys folder and drag it into the keys select here, and then you grab the video folder and you drag it into the video. Now, all you have to do is tell it which keyframes you want to use. In this case, I'm going to use keyframe number 19, and I want it to affect numbers 1 to numbers 207, okay? Then, if I had a second keyframe, for example, if I turn my head or something, and it shows the back of my head or some other look that wasn't completely encapsulated in the keyframe that I gave it, I can always add another one, and it might be, say, for example, frame 150, and I might go ahead and just say, you know, do them all, and then I'll mix them. Or I might say, oh, you know, this one really takes care of everything from, say, 1 to 100, and then this one goes from 101 to 207 or something like that. But you can select as many as you want. And then when you're done with all that, you just say synth, run it for that particular one, or run all. And when you click that, then it will create a new folder called out in the same folder that has the other two folders. And it will start creating images that will be all of the same type as the keyframe image. So it starts with number 19 in my case, then it creates number 18, then it will create number 20, then number 17, number 21, 16, 22, and so on and so forth. When it gets all the way down to 1, then it will just keep going up from there, but it will create all 207 frames. This can take a while, as you can see that it is taking a while to create each one of these frames. This 207 frames will ultimately take about 45 or 50 minutes to get done. And then we'll be able to put it back together in HitFilm. After EB Synth is done with doing its thing, then you will have all of your created frames in one folder. So now it's time to bring them into HitFilm and assemble them back together in the MP4. So if I bring up HitFilm and I just select import and image sequence, and I find the folder that it's in, which is out, select that folder. Now all of a sudden you have your image sequence as a file, as it were. And if I drag it into the timeline, you can see that it is only, of course, the video. It's not the audio, right? But that's okay. What we will do is we'll just drag, holding down the Alt key, I can drag the audio only part of the raw footage, and it will match back up again because both of them were done in 24 frames per second. And so that is basically it in a nutshell. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave them in the comments. Also, if you like this kind of content, consider subscribing to my channel, clicking the little bell icon for notification, sharing this with your friends, liking the video, things like that. And hey, I really appreciate you watching.